Hi, and welcome back to another Scouts Hereford and Worcester YouTube video. Today we're going to be doing my experience on the Great Indoor Weekender. This is the first challenge we've been set. I had to camouflage myself and then reveal myself. Hope you enjoyed the video. Right, so as I explained today, this weekend is the Great Indoors Weekender, and so I'm taking part in the challenges that Gilwell 24 are setting for us. So before I had to camouflage myself and then reveal myself, which is what you saw at the start of the video. The next challenge is we've got to try and create a piece of art using a fitness app. So we've got to go on a walk and try and make our walk create a picture. So here goes. So the third challenge has come in from the Great Indoor Weekender. And this time we've got to try and make the Scout logo out of household objects. So here's what I did for my attempt. As you can see, I decided to use my collection of shoes to make my fleur-de-lis there. Challenge number four is I've got to get an egg as high as I can without breaking it. I think this is pretty high, isn't it? So guys, challenge five has just come in. I've got to film a video that will look good in reverse. So I decided to have a little fun with this, and this is what I came up with. So as you can hopefully see, sorry for the reflection, new challenges come out. I've now got to make a portrait of my favourite celebrity using only toilet rolls. So I'm going to show you me doing this. So I've got my collection of toilet rolls here. I thought I'd go for a recognisable face. It's quite easy. So if we start by making a circle. Put that in the middle. So we've got our circle there, and then we're going to give it some ears, like that. And then using these, we can make a little nose. And that is Mickey Mouse, sort of. So task number seven has just come out. This time I've got to try and make a parachute for a wooden spoon. So, found myself a wooden spoon. I've got this sheet thing that I'm going to try and use as a parachute, and I've got some string. So I'm going to try and tie that to the spoon to make a parachute. Hopefully it goes well. So as you can hopefully see, I've got my parachute here. I've just got one more string to tie on, and then I'm going to give the camera to someone so they can go outside and film me checking it out the window to see if it actually works.
The test flight for our parachute. Let's see. Wow, it sort of worked.
So the parachute with the wooden spoon was sort of successful, but I've decided I'm going to now take it up a level. As you can see, I have attached Humphrey to a parachute, and I'm going to see if I can successfully parachute Humphrey down from my window.
Right, so this is Humphrey's first parachute jumps. So hopefully this goes well. 3, 2, 1.
So as part of the Great Indoor Weekender, we are currently watching the live campfire that they're putting on.
You can follow along, okay? So it goes like this. It goes, I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. Arms out, wrist together. Tootsie bar, tootsie bar, tootsie bar, ba. A tootsie bar, tootsie bar, tootsie bar, ba. I'm singing in the rain. Just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again.
Right, so, this is the next task. It is a little bit late because I had to go and do something, but it was to see how quickly I could put the cover on a duvet. Apparently, the world record is 39 seconds. Not sure I'm going to beat that, but who knows. So we'll give it a go. It's one, three. Three, two, one, go! Done. Now, I'm not quite sure how long that was because I haven't actually seen the timer, but I think that was quicker than 39 seconds. So actually looking into the world record, I don't think I quite did it right. I did it with a smaller duvet and I was touching it to start with, but I'm still very happy with my attempt and I'm gonna class that as a win. So the next challenge is I got to try and create a spot the difference. So for this one, I'm not going to show you me setting it up, because obviously that would ruin it. So instead, I'm going to show you the two pictures. I'm going to put one on the screen, and then I'm going to put the other one on the screen. And I want you to send in what you think the difference is to staysafe@scoutshw.org.uk. Hopefully some of you will get it right. Good luck. So the next challenge that's just come up, as you can see, it's there behind me, is I've got to try and create a video to accompany a nursery rhyme. Now, I had a thought about this, and I couldn't really think of how I could film a video with the stuff that I've got. So instead, I'm going to take some photos and try and create a short, like an animation sort of video to go with the nursery rhyme. So hopefully you'll see that in a minute, and hopefully it'll be good.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm he had some cows, E-I-E-I-O. You're a moo, you're a moo there, you're a moo, there a moo, everywhere a moo moo. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Hi, just a little quick check-in. So obviously this is a 24-hour challenge and I just wanted to show you the sunset. Probably can't see much because there's a tree in the way, but it's looking really nice tonight. As you can see, look, the sky's looking pretty good. And that's the view of my sunset that I've got. So we have just done the Not a Pub quiz for the Gilwell 24 challenges. Unfortunately, I forgot to film. I didn't do very well. The rounds weren't... the questions weren't quite things that I knew, but yeah, it was really good fun. It's just maybe we're just not clever enough for these quizzes. So I'm a bit behind with timings on my challenges, but the next challenge I'm going to be attempting is the take an extraordinary photo of an ordinary object. So I'm going to have a look now to see what I've got and see what photo ideas I can come up with. So I found this Coke bottle and this Pringles can, and I had this idea of trying to take a photo of the Pringles can through the Coke bottle. So I'm going to see if I can get this to work. So if we put this on here, and then line that up like that, and take a photo there. Hopefully, that looks really good. I'll show you the results now. So like I said, I was a bit behind my challenges, so I'm doing this challenge straight after the last one. And this time I've got to make an unexpected silhouette or shadow. So I don't quite know what I'm going to do with this one. So I'll get back to you when I've thought of something. But I'm going to see what I can think of now. So this is going to be my attempt at the shadow challenge. So they said that it had to be an unexpected silhouette or shadow. So let's try this. So we've got our standard dog. That's pretty standard. But then boom! Oh look, now it's a reindeer. Bet you weren't expecting that. So the next activity that we're meant to be doing doesn't seem to have gone live on Facebook at the moment, and maybe they're a little bit late, but it's meant to be making landmarks out of rubbish that you've got in your house and stuff. So here is what I have attempted to do. So as you can see, with some toilet rolls, I have made my own mini Burj Khalifa. So that is the landmark that I've decided to make. So the Burj Khalifa is the tallest building in the world. This isn't the tallest tower ever, but I think it gives a good representation of it. So the next challenge has been released. I've got to see how many socks I can put on 1 foot in 30 seconds. Right, so I'll just set this up and then let's see how many I can get on my feet. So for this challenge, I've got a timer set up on my tablet that should go off at 30 seconds. And then let's just see how many socks I can get on. So I'm just going to pop the camera there. I say, okay, so we're going to start in 3, 2, 1, go. Socks really getting hard. So that's time up. So let's see how many I got on. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Oh. So I managed to get the 6 socks in 30 seconds. I don't know if that's good or not. But yeah, that's how well I did. So there we go, that's the next challenge completed. So we are just currently watching this video that's teaching us how to make a hand warmer, or like a microwavable hot water bottle sort of thing. So I'm going to watch this and then see how that's done. So we finished watching the video on how to make the hand warmers, and because of all the things that you need to make it, I'm not going to make one, but if I remember to, I'll put a try and find the video and put a link below this video so that you can go and have a look to see how to make one if you want to. So it's now 10 past 12, and I've just seen the next challenge. I've got to try and paint a rainbow in the dark. Now, I don't have any paints, so I won't be painting it, but I'm going to try this with some coloured pens and see how it turns out. So what I need to do is turn all the lights off and see if I can draw a rainbow in the dark. So, as you can see, it's dark. I've just got one more line to do on my rainbow. There we go. So I've done that. We're now going to turn the lights on and see what I came out with. Oh, that wasn't too bad. I managed to not cross over any lines, so I'm quite happy with that. But that's my rainbow that I did in the dark. So it's quarter past midnight currently. Just thought I'd do a little update of how I'm doing during this 24-hour challenge. Feeling alright at the moment, but I think I'm going to start getting quite tired soon. But hopefully, if you can hear that, that's Scout Radio playing in the background. And I think this is going to be something that's going to hopefully help me keep going. I think just listening to the movie, having a little groove about, I think that's what's going to keep me going throughout this 24 hours. Hopefully I can make it all the way through. So yeah, I'm doing all right at the moment, and I'll check in with you when the next challenge comes through. So it is 12 now, and the next challenge has just come in. And it says I've got to see how many tea bags I can get to land in a cup when throwing from a distance. So I'm going to go and find a cup and some tea bags and give this challenge a go. So I've got myself 5 tea bags here, and you might be able to see that up there. There's a cup just there at the top of the stairs. I'm going to see if I can get any of these tea bags in that cup. So here goes. That was rubbish. So didn't get any in. I'll collect those up and have another go. Right, we're going to try it from a little bit closer this time. See if I can get in this time. Nope, looks like I'm just really bad at throwing tea bags. So yep, seems like throwing tea bags is not a strong point for me. I think we're going to have to call that task a fail. But hopefully I'll do a bit better on the next one that comes through. So we are currently now doing the mystery spy hunt thing. And this is the first lot of clues that we've got. So we are looking through all the evidence that's coming in, and all that's really occurred to us is it's too late to be thinking this hard about things. It is now 1:30, and the next challenge has come out. I've got to go outside and see what I can see in the night sky. So I'll take you outside and let's have a look what we can see. So, because there's streetlights and stuff, I can't see too much. Can't seem to see the moon, which is strange, but I can see the Big Dipper in front of me. And what else can I see? And that's about it. I don't know of any more constellations, to be honest. But I can definitely see the Big Dipper. So I can see the North Star as well. But yeah, can't see the moon. So it is now 2:00 in the morning, and we spent an hour trying to solve the mystery of the missing Max Crystal. And so far, we are not doing very well because we haven't figured out anything, but hopefully we will soon. So by the looks of it, this is the last bit of information we're getting to try and figure out what has happened to Max, and we have come to the conclusion that we still don't know, but it might be Jeff. But we'll find out in the morning, apparently. So, yeah, we're not very good at being detectives, is the main thing that's come out of this, I think. It is now 2:40. Getting very tired now, but got to keep pushing through. The next challenge has
been released, and I've got to make the word kindness with objects from my kitchen. So I'm going to go and find some objects now and try and write the word kindness with them. So as you can see here, I've written out kindness with all of these utensils from the kitchen. There we go. So it's now 3:15. Just watched the Get Creative video they've put on, and they've challenged us to try and recreate a piece of artwork using things from our house. So I'm going to have a go at that now. I'm going to try and find a piece of artwork that I can hopefully recreate. So for my art piece, I decided to create something similar to this. And this is what I came up with. So to create the black lines, I've used cables, and then I've used some like notepads and pencil cases and stuff to make the coloured bits. It is now 3:30. I've gone past the bit where I'm feeling really tired, and I actually feel like I might be able to stay awake for a bit longer now. But the next challenge has come in for me, so it is to craft a small version of something big, or a big version of something small. So don't quite know what I'm going to do for this one yet, but I'll get back to you when I've thought of something. This may be cheating slightly with the task, but this is something that I've made previously. So here is a normal size Necker, and I made a miniature Necker that is the ideal size for Humphrey. So that is my mini version of a normal size Necker. So it is now 4:30. This last hour's been very difficult, I've noticed myself. Start falling asleep, but I've managed to keep awake still. And I've got another challenge now. I've got to create a stop motion film starring a potato. So I need to go and find a potato and see that. And also it has started getting light now. I don't know if you'll be able to see this through here. But look, it has actually started to get light again. So I'm going to go and find a potato and see if I can make a stop-start animation with it. It is currently about 5:00 in the morning. And according to the website I was looking at, sunrise is at 5:05. So I came out just to see if I could see it. There's some houses in the way, so hopefully I'll be able to get a nice view of it when it actually comes up. But I thought it'd be nice to have seen sunrise and sunset on the same night. So it's now 5:30, the next challenge has just come out, and it says fake a band. So I think this is a perfect opportunity for me to get out the guitar that I can't actually play and pretend to play it with the backing track of an actual song.
Right, got my guitar and I'm ready.
Go!
So, in a minute, there's meant to be a Zumba class starting. That's right. I'm going to be doing Zumba at 6 o'clock in the morning. So, I'm going to leave this film in and I'm going to do the Zumba and you'll probably see some of it that I do. So, enjoy. So the next challenge has just been released, and this time we've got to create an interesting film in either fast or slow motion. So let's give that a go. So it is now 8:45. Very tired now, but I'm still managing to stay awake. At 9:00, they're meant to be doing some live yoga on Facebook. So I'm going to join in with that. I'll film that so you can see bits of that.
Here as well. Try and connect into that right ball of the foot and the left foot. Right, now come up. Now change the grip. So we're now going to hold on to the right wrist of the left hand. Then I'm going to center. And again, inhale, lift, look up, arms together, breathing out, pull down again through your center. Very good. And again, inhale, lift, look up, arms together here. That this knee isn't rolling in, so it's very straight. This knee is going over the front of the ankle. Can you now start to bring your chest towards this front leg? Maybe get the fingertips to the floor, keep the back straight, stay. I'm really thinking about sticking my bottom out behind me, and I'm going to feel a stretch in this right hip there.
There we go, that's the yoga finished. So it is just coming up to 9:30, which means I've got 2 hours left until the 24 hours is over. So I've decided the best way to help get me through these last few hours is food. So I'm going to have some breakfast now. So we've got our final Taskmaster challenge that's been put up. And it says I've got to solve a world problem. Now, I don't really know how I can solve a world problem. Maybe you guys have got some suggestions. Maybe if you send in your suggestions to stay safe at scouts.hw.org.uk. because I don't really know what I could do. But you guys might have some great ideas. Soon is about to start the talk about the WWF, which should be the last activity I'm doing in my 24 hours. After this, I should be finished. And that should be the 24 hours done. And then hopefully I can get some sleep. So it's now gone past 11:30, which means I have officially finished the 24 hours. I've had great fun doing all the challenges, but I think it's definitely time to go to sleep now. So until the next video, have fun and stay safe.